Well, I mean, I was a fan of the original series. I only got to watch it, you know, kind of the beginnings of it, because then I started doing Chuck, and we were on the same network, and then I was working every day, and I didn't watch any television. I barely showered. It was really a tragic time in my life, but it's really fun to kind of bring that world back and bring that back to the original viewers and also hopefully new viewers. And Judy and I play two very interesting, complicated, twisted characters who kill a lot of people. And so there's that. Very not happy-go-lucky like Chuck was years ago. But we've had a great time. Toronto's been very kind to us. We're still shooting the show.
Yeah.
And the weather's fantastic now, so.
Yes. Shooting in Toronto during the summer is the best ever. In the winter, it's a little bit cold. But it's been thrilling. I think the new Heroes is maybe a little darker than the original. I think you'll find it a very complex world, very complex characters, definitely the relationships. And also you get to see, now that people with special powers are out in the open in this one, you get to see how they relate to people without special powers and the separation. And you get to see some themes that are going on in the world today.
I don't know that it's a metaphor for the classes like that, but I definitely think there's a civil rights backdrop to it about people that are different.
Yeah.
And how do you coexist in a world with people that are different? And obviously this difference is pretty massive. You know, it's not just the color of our skin. It's, well, I have to walk and you can fly somewhere. You know, that's very different. Or you're shooting lasers out of your eyes, you know.
And I think as well the element of one group having more power than the other, or perceiving someone else as being more powerful. And so how does that make you react? And how does that make you behave in their presence? And what does that make you feel? Yeah. So I think there's fear there. And I think, you know, fear is going on all around us in the world. So I think definitely you'll see things that have meaning to people based on what's going on in the world today. We're killing a few people. Just one or two, though. It's not a big deal. You know?
When something happens to us, there's a massive event, this terrorist attack that's blamed on people with abilities. Our son dies. It's very tragic. And it sends us down a dark rabbit hole of vengeance for our son and what we think is making the world a safer place. Yeah. So we're not bad guys as much as just misunderstood.
Exactly. We think we've got a calling, or I would say my character thinks she's got a calling, thinks she's on a mission, thinks she's doing what's right since she's lost her son. And I think you go through the journey to see whether it is or not.
I was in a room once that was on fire, and that was awesome. I didn't feel like I was in danger. I mean, we go through the whole safety protocol and... You know, we lit it on fire, and I had to do my scene and exit the room before I caught on fire. And I could feel the flames. Like, I could feel them. It was really warm. But it didn't burn me. It was, you know, I knew what I was doing. Yeah. And then that whole room burned down. It was amazing.
I saw the video. We do quite a lot with guns, and it's quite exciting, you know, with feeling the recoil if you get to experience it and the sound of it. And I've done quite a bit of running and jumping and stuff like that, so it's helped me keep in shape.
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I think the first two seasons of Heroes were really big and really impactful. I hope that our 13 episodes finds its voice somewhere in that. Yeah.
I think they're like two children. You've got the younger child and the older child, and I'm not going to pick between them. I love them both. It's not Sophie's choice. I won't do it.